Hello students, in your part 1 of the audio, we have discussed about French Revolution, French society, the struggle for the survival. We discussed about growing middle class and the philosophers of the era. That is, we discussed page 3 to 7 of your chapter 1, NCRT, French Revolution. Now moving forward to page 8, the outbreak of the revolution. Under this, we will talk about the calling of the meeting of the state journals. From here, the real problem will start. First, understand the meaning of the state journals. The state journal was a political body to which the three estates, nobility, clergy, and the third estate, sent their representatives. You know that France was going through financial crisis. This we have discussed when the Louis XVI, he ascended the throne of France in 1774 and he found the empty treasury. In France, during old regime, the monarch did not have the power to impose taxes according to his own will alone. So, rather he has to call a meeting of the state journals, which would then pass his proposal for the new taxes. It means that if in order to introduce any new tax, the king has to call a meeting of the state journals. So on 5th May 1789, Louis XVI called together an assembly of the state journal to pass proposal for the new taxes. Now please understand here, the first and the second estate, that is clergy and nobility, they used to send 300 representatives each to the meeting of state journal. Means clergy will also send 300 representatives and nobility will also send 300 representatives, members or delegates. While the third state alone used to send 600 members. In the past, voting in the state journal had been conducted according to the principle that each state had one vote. Means clergy will be counted as one vote, nobility will also be counted as a one vote, and the third state will also be counted as a one vote. Kings want to continue with the same practice. But the third state demanded that voting now be conducted by the assembly as a whole, where each member would have one vote. So this was according to the democratic principles put forward by Rousseau in his book Social Contract. When the king rejected this proposal, members of the third estate walked out of the assembly in protest and they moved to the tennis court, where they took the oath that we will not disperse until and unless we will enact the constitution of the France. Now we will see the tennis court oath. On 20th June 1789, the representatives of the third estate assembled at the indoor tennis court in Versailles. They declared themselves a national assembly. They gave themselves the power to pass laws on the behalf of the French people. Now here, national assembly means what the state journals became after the tennis court oath. They were led by Mirabeau. He was born in a noble family, and Abbesses, he was a priest. Mirabeau delivered powerful speeches to the assembled crowd, and Abbesses, he used to write a pamphlet which is called What is the Third Estate. While the National Assembly was busy at Versailles drafting the constitution, the rest of the France was in turmoil. In the rest of the France, the condition was of chaos and confusion. Now we will see the storming of Bastille. If you remember, your chapter starts from this event only. The day was 14 July 1789. Due to severe winter, the harvest was not good. The prices of the bread rose and the hoarders exploited the situation. There was not enough supply of their daily bread. So as a result, angry women stormed into the shops, and on 14 July, the agitated, angry crowd stormed and destroyed Bastille, the fortress prison. The end of July and the beginning of August, there were many riots in the countryside. Peasants burned their noble castles, their residence, and destroyed documents which contained their feudal obligations. So this was Great Fear of 1789, that is the revolts which happened in the countryside between peasants and lords. Now new development happened because of this ongoing revolts of this his subjects. Louis XVI finally given recognition to the National Assembly. He accepted that his powers would now be checked by the constitution. So this was one of the major development or the events at that time. So further now on 4 August 1789, the Assembly passed a law abolishing feudal dues and taxes. The members of the clergy were also forced to give up their privileges. Tithes were abolished. Land owned by the church was also confiscated, was also seized. Now moving to page 10 of your chapter. The National Assembly drafted the Constitution of 1791. The objective of this constitution was to limit the powers of the monarch. Now the powers were distributed to different institutions, the legislature, executive and judiciary. It means the powers now were taken from the monarchy. Now the constitution which was enacted in 1791, it began with the declaration of the rights of men and citizens. Now certain rights were given to citizens under this like right to life, freedom of speech, equality before law. Now let's discuss some of the democratic features of this constitution which was enacted in 1791. According to this constitution, France became a limited monarchy, or you can say constitutional monarchy. King now will be merely the head of the state. All laws were created by the legislative assembly and feudalism was also abolished. So these were the democratic features. Now let's see certain undemocratic features of this constitution. Voting was limited to the taxpayers only. The concept of active and passive citizens came up. Active citizen means those who are having voting rights, that is men above 25 years of age who paid taxes. They only will be having voting rights. And the passive citizen means the remaining men and all women were called passive citizens and they don't have any voting rights. Now moving to page 11 of your chapter. On this page, it is given that the constitution began with the declaration of the rights of men and citizen. Here the certain rights were given to the French citizens now, like right to life, freedom of speech, opinion, equality before law, and it was the duty of the state to protect each citizen's natural rights. Now moving to page 12 and 13 of your chapter, here certain symbols are given. So you should identify these symbols and mention their significance also, like broken chain. It means the act of becoming free. Then the bundle of rods, eye within the triangle. Then the red liberty cap, which is a symbol of liberty.